Hi there, your computer friend Connie here. Have you ever struggled with trying to make an appointment with somebody else? Maybe that's somebody within your own company or organization. Maybe that's somebody external, like maybe a customer or a vendor, potential customer. Or maybe that's with a volunteer organization that you help out with. Maybe you're on a committee or you're on the board. And trying to make everybody's calendar jive together is so hard. How many emails could you possibly send to figure out what's the best date for everybody? I'm going to show you just how to get around that, how to automate that whole process. So having a scheduling program is so much easier for that. So what you have on the screen here with me is my Mission Computer scheduling page, and this is using Microsoft. So if you have Microsoft 365 for business, there's a few versions of Microsoft 365 that has this product available in it. It's already there. You don't have to buy anything new. You already have it. Maybe you don't even know it. So this is called Bookings. So it's called Microsoft Bookings. And this is what my page looks like when someone goes to visit it. If I say, hey, go to my, I just send them the link in an email, and then they click on the link and they see this page come up. And so if they're like, oh yeah, you know what, I want Connie to do, let's see, a demo of something. So if they click on technology demo, they click on that. Okay. You'll see, and actually you can't see on my screen maybe, but below, it's actually showing a calendar. So it's saying on August 10th, these are all the time slots I have open. So it actually looks at my calendar within my Outlook. It's syncing with Outlook automatically because it is a Microsoft product. And it's saying, hey, Connie's got lots of openings here. She's got on Monday, she's got all these times available. But notice today is Thursday and I have no times open on Friday. So it says no available times. It's and Saturday and Sunday, it's saying that because I have that crossed off as not an option for so you can specify, you know, which days of the week do I work, what times of the day do I want to have appointments, and a few other cool things that I'll show you in a minute. But if you look, okay, so let's say Monday's no good for you, you click on Tuesday, you've only got three options on Tuesday. Let's go to Wednesday, lots of options on Wednesday. Hey, this should be blocked off, that's my anniversary. Hopefully the hubby's going to take me somewhere special and I can block out the whole day. But yeah, so that's what it looks like right now. So and this is dynamic. This is the cool thing about it. So if I go into my calendar 10 minutes from now or like after this session and I block off the day on the 12th, then when you click on it, it won't be available. Well, actually, you won't be able to click on it because it won't be available to you. So as soon as I do something in my calendar, it changes this. And so this is why I like using it, because I know for years I've just done the same old, you know, the same old process where someone emails me and says, hey, Connie, can you come and teach this group of people on Thursday or Friday? What time does he have open? And they might be talking about Friday next week. And I say, yeah, sure, I can come on Friday. And then 2 days later, they send me an email going, actually, Friday doesn't work. How about Thursday? And I'm like, ah. Oh. Okay, well, Thursday, yeah, I have this time at 1 o'clock. And then by the time I send it to them, that gets booked. And so it's not dynamic. We're emailing back and forth so much. So it's so much better if you know, if they have a change or I have a change, you know, it's easy enough to change. So if someone wants to rebook, not an issue because they just click on the link again and see what openings does she have tomorrow or next week. And that's all available there. So let's just show you how to get this. And so you'll see if you were booking an appointment with me using this system, you'd pick that date, you'd pick a time, and then you type in your name, your email. You probably should give me your phone number unless you don't expect me to ever phone you. But for appointments, it might be better. And then anything you want to tell me about that. And then you'd hit book, and that would send me an email, and it would also put an appointment in my calendar. So it actually already schedules me. So that's kind of cool too, right? It puts it in there. Okay, and then I can of course email you back. And but that's your confirmation. You don't even really need a confirmation from me, but I think I do confirm anyways with people. So that's Microsoft. That's what this one looks like when you use it. This is all customizable. These times are all, again, as I said earlier, this is something for you to choose what time slots you want to have open or not. And then this stuff you can customize as well in terms of what information you need from people. So let's show you where you do that. So I'm going to go into what's the back end of it. So this is, so just so you know how I got here, you'd have to go to your Microsoft login on the web. So to log into Microsoft. And then once you do, you'd go to this waffle, which is a menu on the top left, and you click on that. And so bookings is right there, kind of front and center for me, but it may not be. You might still have it. So you may want to just double check this if you have Microsoft. And if you don't see it here, just go to all apps. And when you go to all apps, it alphabetizes it. So guess what? Bookings is way at the top. If you see an A and no B, then that means you don't have it included in your Microsoft product. And as far as I know, it's not a free product because it has to integrate with your Exchange environment and your everything to do with your Outlook and stuff. So unless Microsoft changes that, but it's not free. So if you have Microsoft, then that's why you want to pay attention to this. All right, so let's just show you a few things. I'm not going to take too long at this. There's a lot in here, but I want to just show you a few options available to you. So starting with in my booking page, what I can do is say what my time increments are. So see how it says time increments? So I could say it's 30 minutes or whatever time increment I want to have for that particular appointment. And by the way, I'm on a particular appointment. So this is for one of the appointments that I have listed. I have multiple types of appointments, and I'll show you how to make multiple in a second here. So maximum lead time. So what that means is, I mean, do you want to get a booking for something 10 minutes from now? You know, maybe if I had a clothing store and, if it's COVID, I probably still need to have some kind of lead time. So maybe I'd need 10 minutes or 15 minutes because it's looking for openings in the calendar, by the way. So it can't double book you in this scenario. Now, that being said, if you have multiple employees, you could have one customer with one employee, one customer with another employee, and so on, right? So that's just how this particular one would work, right? But so for me, I'm having to teach you something, or maybe we're having a consulting call of some kind. I do need some lead time. So to prepare for that and to know more about you. So I give myself 24 hours is what that shows here. Okay, so that's the minimum lead time. And then there's maximum lead times in terms of days in advance. So this is saying, so this is in hours, 24 hours. And in terms of days in advance, so you know, here, this is my, when I was doing face-to-face training more so, and I had lots of clients that were looking at, you know, what do you have available in the next quarter or the next month or whatever. So I did have to give them my calendar open far into the future. So this is 90 days, 3 months into the future, they can see, okay, what openings does she have? And then they can book something, right? Let's go over to the staff is something, I mean, I'm not using that because I only have one. There's only one of me showing in here. I do have a couple of other people that work with me, but they're not showing as staff members because they're not doing the consulting that I'm doing. So that's nothing extra there. Services. So here's where what you saw on that first page comes about, because this is where you actually can add a service. So if I hit add a service, you'd see what the name of the service is, describe it a bit, and then you have the details. So what's kind of cool here, right? Let's say I am that clothing store, then maybe I want to have a little bit of buffer time. So even though my calendar shows I have an opening at 1 o'clock this afternoon or 2 o'clock this afternoon, if I just finish with a client at, 12:30 or 1:30, I want a little bit of buffer time between clients. So that's where I can say, yes, I need buffer time. So even though my calendar is open, give me an extra 15 minutes. So for me, I use buffer time a lot with my clients when I was going to visit them face to face, because I would need to give myself travel time. So if they booked in my calendar, hey, Connie's free at 1 o'clock. If I was at a client's until 12:30, that only gives me half an hour. I don't know where they are, that's new client that's booking me, compared to where I am currently. So I have to give myself, like say, an hour travel time in between my appointment. Maximum number of attendees. So that's kind of a neat option. So that's where, you know, again, back to that clothing store example, maybe she's bringing people with her. So they want to have four people in the store. So then, you know, you can see how many people are coming into appointments and how many people you can have in your store and stuff like that. And then you can put a price on this. Now this doesn't tie into, just gonna say, it doesn't tie into like PayPal or anything like that, where it actually, no, I could be wrong. I don't use it for that. So if it did tie into, there might be some extra programming needed. But you can certainly give people the price so they know what it is. But as far as charging them, you might have to use another product for that. Just so you know, there is some options for email notifications. So are you going to notify the person that's booking the appointment that appointment's coming up? So it's a good idea, right, to notify them by email that you've made the appointment, or they've made the appointment. So it's obviously going to notify you because they're on your calendar booking the appointment for you. So kind of a neat tool to use. I'm not going to save this, so we'll just discard that. All right, so this is kind of what I'm showing here. The default price, I'm not giving prices on my page here, whether there's payment required, and then what staff's assigned. There is some customization that you can do within your booking page as well, which is what this shows, like different colors. And then if I go back to, actually let's go back to here. So that's what it looks like, right? So that's what the customer or the other person sees. All right, so thanks for watching. I'm gonna sign off now. Bye-bye.